So, Jump Festa is literally around the corner, being in a few days' time, being on the 17th of December. And of course, with every Jump Festa that comes along, I of course do a video giving my predictions on this, and people have a lot of speculations of what to get at Jump Festa. And this Jump Festa is a little bit different from previous Jump Festas, seeing as for the past years of Jump Festa, we've always speculated the anime return or an anime trailer or something exciting along those lines. But this is the first Jump Festa that we've ever had where we actually have the anime, so we have to kind of think a little bit outside the box on what we can truly predict with this year. So stick around, like and subscribe to the video if you like this type of content, and of course we'll live stream the event as well on the day of its happening. So let's get into it, shall we? Just like last year, Bleach will have its own Super Stage under the Extra title. This will of course be pre-recorded and will have English translations for overseas viewers, which is good because we don't have to kind of guess what things are being said for once. With that being said, and I can't remember where I did see it, so if I'm wrong, I'm wrong and I apologise, but Kubo will be at this Jump Festa as well as many of the voice actors, and quite a few of them at that as well. Now I do have to be very specific with this panel because this is a Bleach only panel, because in the previous years it was Bleach and Burn the Witch or slash Burn the Witch, but this is specifically a Bleach panel in and of itself, so there will be no Burn the Witch as far as we are concerned in regards to the title of this panel. However, Bandai Namco will be having their own little Burn the Witch booth, not a panel but a booth, and things at this Bandai booth will be giving us acrylic stands, t-shirts, canvas boards, Blu-rays, and of course a photo arena of Nini, so you can go take a picture with her, to which of course she is best girl after all, and it was a wise decision to make. As well as a surprising little thing, because when Burn the Witch was happening, there was going to be some figures that were going to be released, but this figure release never really came out, and this is because Kubo didn't really like how the figures were looking, so there was a lot of trials and errors to get this figures, or these figures in general, kind of accurate to what Kubo designed. And as you can see, they are on screen. I'm not going to speak too much about them, because if I do, every time I see Nini, a primal instinct comes out in me that I do not wish to talk about. But they look amazing. And look, if you like Noelle, you like Noelle. But let's just be honest, the pose and the face looks just better on Nini. It's just, it is what it is. I don't make the rules, I just enforce them. Now, I'm sure many of you will question whether there was something in the Weekly Shonen Jump magazine about Jump Festa, and the answer is no. Because Weekly Shonen Jump, as of a few years ago, just do not leak things on Weekly Shonen Jump anymore, because I think they're very well aware that people in general do get them early and do leak the event, so they just don't post them in the magazine anymore. So if you're expecting Weekly Shonen Jump to give you anything in regards to that, yet the answer is no. However, what this week's magazine did entail, or the leaks of what will be on Monday after the Jump Festa event, the only thing that it really did give us was the confirmation, which was already told to us by the social media account of the Bleach anime, was that episodes 12 and 13 were going to be simultaneously put together, in a sense, making it essentially 40 minutes to an hour, depending if there's an opening and an ending. It's going to be an hour long episode, which in and of itself is extremely exciting, and it's going to take me quite a while to edit that live reaction, but nonetheless I'm excited, and that's going to be on Boxing Day or on the 26th, the 26th of Christmas, 26th of December, James, come on. So that's the only thing we got a confirmation of. So I did post a tweet asking what people's predictions are, and to be completely realistic, excluding games, and people still asked for a Bleach game anyway, but I asked people anyway to give their predictions, and here's what their predictions are and kind of my take on them, and then at the end of the video I will be giving what my overall prediction is going to be on what we're going to be essentially getting. First and foremost, Burn the Witch news in general, I don't think that this is happening at all. I do think things maybe got postponed, and I don't think it's really on Kubo's list at the moment, even though I would say in terms of the manga it's probably done. I don't think we're going to get an announcement per se. It is possible, of course, but I think it's extremely unlikely, since as this is a Bleach panel, and I think if we're going to get any news on Burn the Witch, it is going to be in 2023, maybe the first quarter in regards to its manga. So with that being said, I'm unfortunately not going to be holding my breath in terms of Burn the Witch news in general at Jump Festa. However, considering there is a lot of merchandise being shown and it has its own little booth, so to say, goes to show that there is still interest in terms of Bandai's interest, so that's exciting nonetheless. Another thing is the Hell arc announcement for Bleach, and while I do think that this is plausible, in the future, I don't think it's going to be the case for this Jump Festa in general. Again, Kubo's too busy working on the Thousand Year Blood War arc and probably Burn the Witch as well, so chances are it's going to be something that is going to be announced way later on in the future. Maybe there'll be a passing comment from the voice actors or maybe Kubo himself, but I'm not expecting an announcement per se, but maybe an opinion piece from Kubo himself. Plausibly. Then there's the prediction of the second core or the second season of the Thousand Year Blood War arc. I think that's extremely plausible in terms of the date of when we're going to get it. So people are, you know, hopefully fingers crossed on that. And I do think that that's completely plausible. People are also asking for a key visual or anime poster for Everything But the Rain or the second core. I don't think Everything But the Rain will have its own key visual per se, though I do think they're gassing up this mini arc a little bit. So I'm not going to say no, but I do think it's very unlikely. I do think, however, it is very possible to get a key visual for the second core. Then we have Bleach Expo news and possibly overseas releases, and I do think that this is plausible. I think Bleach Expo has been going on for a really, really long time, possibly like over a year now, definitely over a year. Surely by now that Bleach Expo has been going on, and maybe because I follow Bleach away too much that I notice it more, but as far as I'm concerned, that this is the longest possibly that an expo for a Jump series has been going, or an exhibit in terms of an art museum. So it is possible for overseas, and the reason why I say this is that recently we have Club Outside, which is Kubo's own little fan club, and that had a booth at one of the Korean exhibits or Korean expos. I can't remember which one it was, but you'll see a picture on screen, and that is really telling to me and very exciting to see that whatever expo you have, maybe it's Anime Expo or MCM Expo in London or whatever expo that you have in the West, it is quite plausible that you might actually get, if not a Club Outside thing, you might actually have a Burn the Witch art exhibition that we've been getting in Japan. Will we get an announcement at Jump Festa? I think it might be a passing comment, but again, it is plausible. People, of course, want a Thousand Year Blood War data book, and I feel like maybe this will potentially happen maybe after Core 2, when we've been introduced to a lot more of the characters, and would make more sense to market a data book in that sort of case. If not a data book by Kubo, definitely maybe a data book by Studio Pierrot in general. So I definitely see that as a plausible thing. I think it would be called an animation data book at that point, rather than a manga data book, but regardless of what, we're just playing semantics with words there. And then, of course, a novel adaptation. Will we get the novels animated? And I think this won't really be confirmed until we get a Jump Festa where we're on the last core. And then, of course, last but not least, a Bleach game. And the reason why I said in this tweet not to mention a Bleach game, because 99% of the time is that you never get anime game announcements at Jump Festa, full stop, unless... And I mean, unless maybe it's a mobile game announcement. But then again, it's not really an announcement. Maybe it's a showcase for like maybe the Haikyuu smartphone game, for example. But we already knew that that was coming, so demonstrating it at Jump Festa wouldn't be something out the ordinary. Having a game announcement is just, and I'm pretty sure some of you might tell me in the comments some game announcements, but it is extremely rare. And things like that are just left for maybe something like Tokyo Game Show, for example, or maybe even E3. So I'm not really holding my breath for a Bleach game, and I don't think anyone should either. I think it's an unrealistic expectation considering Jump Festa's is past. So what are my predictions in all of this? What do I think we're going to be getting within this Jump Festa? And unfortunately, I have to say it's probably going to be a nothing burger, considering I've been following Jump Festa for such a long time. And for the majority of the part, you're going to be having a bunch of voice actors there that are going to answer some questions. And I think Morita in this screenshot that I'm showing kind of alludes this as well, where they get to really just talk about maybe the production, maybe their thoughts and feelings on the series, and maybe just some questions for Kubo here and there. But I think the majority of this is going to be maybe 30 minutes of them just talking, shooting the shit, talking about the production, X, Y, and Z, nothing too special, just some voice actors just talking. And then maybe the last 10 minutes is maybe going to be showing like an overview of the whole series maybe, and then maybe a key visual. I think a key visual is very prominent of our lowest expectation, because I think a key visual, considering when we got the first key visual of Bleach with Ichigo in just the all orange background, it is easy to do, it is very easy to manufacture, and it gets good for, you know, merchandising for later on when Core 2 comes to release. I do think Core 2 will have an announcement date as well. I think, you know, that can be slided in there as well. I personally think, you know, a gap of 6 to 9 months would be at least the bare minimum for Bleach. I don't really want it any earlier than that, because I guess we can talk about that after the Bleach anime ends in terms of Core 1 and really deep dive into that and give you my opinions on that. But realistically, that's all I think it is. And it may be a nothing burger video, but people like to hear these thoughts. And I don't want anyone to get too excited over something that's going to be potentially disappointing. But I'm very excited to see how Burn the Witch is perceived and as well as the Bleach panel itself. And I do think a key visual is completely fine and expected in this regard. I think what people are asking for in terms of like the games and the data books and the novel adaptations and even the Hell arc to some extent, that's just for way later on. It is way too premature to even discuss these things now because we're nowhere near even towards the end of Bleach, and these things are after Bleach anime stuff. Except for the game, maybe, of course, but you know, you gotta give those games time to develop, especially if you want a good game. I think it was Piroshi of CC2 that said good games, or the games that they work on, usually takes anywhere from 3 to 4 years. So you kind of really want to let a game company to let them cook a little bit before they release something, because I think you would all prefer a good game rather than a rushed game, instead of something like a Fairy Tail or a One Punch Man or a My Hero game that literally takes years of development and then they just throw it out there because they know it's going to make money. So sorry, I might have disappointed some people, I don't know, but of course tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think is going to be at Jump Fest, anything that I might have missed or any ideas that I might have missed as well. But of course I'm excited to hear what Kubo has to say, I'm excited to hear what the voice actors have to say, because sometimes they do a little bit of slip ups here and now and then, they mention something that really makes you question the head, as well as Morita even saying that he wishes that there was more Hellverse or more of the Hell arc, so to say, in the last Jump Festa. And I believe even someone that worked at Shueisha at the time said that there was a lot of demand for it, if I'm going based off memory. So that's always a good sign. And considering that Kubo even said himself on his Club Outside private fan club, even said that, you know, Shueisha have asked him to do more, goes to show that there's a lot of interest, not only on Shueisha's part, not only the voice actor's part, but I'm sure on investors' part as well. So I do think that even after the Thousand Blood War arc has finished, I don't think it's the end for Bleach. But if you like this video, click the like and subscribe. And of course, with that being said, you guys, of course, have this fine day, been handsome. And as always, people, peace out.